Now we are going to study uncompensated network. So uncompensated network means all the capacitor has been transferred to receiving end. So this will be Z, this will be Z, and this will be Y, this will be Y. So this will be Z and this will be Y, and this is, let us assume a load is connected, RL load is connected like this. So RL load is connected like this, and this is the receiving end voltage VR, this is the receiving end voltage VR, and this is the receiving end current IR, and this is sending end voltage VS, and this is sending end current IS. So what we can see from here, that if we want to write first that the ABCD parameter, so we can break this into two parts, and we can write the VS, IS, VS, IS is equal to 1, Z, 0, 1. This is the first part, and this is the second part, 1, 0, Y, 1. And here it will be VR, IR. So here it will be VR and IR, and now what we can write, this VS and this IS, this VS and this IS is equal to multiplying by both. So this will become 1 plus YZ, basically 1 plus YZ, and this is Z, this is Y, and this is 1. So this will become VR and IR, this will become VR and IR. So this will become VR and IR. So now we can multiply this. We can multiply this VS IS is equal to VS IS is equal to, here it will become 1 plus YZ Z Y 1 VR and IR. So now we want to represent if in terms of ABCD parameter this uncompensated network. So simply we can convert like this. This will be our Z is equal to B, and this is C, this is C. So this is our VSIS and this is VRIR. So this is how we can represent uncompensated network. So these are the ABCD parameter. Now I am going to draw the phasor diagram for this uncompensated network. To draw the phasor diagram, VS will be equal to VR, this is VR, plus IS into Z, plus IS into Z. So VS is equal to VR plus IS into Z. And we also know that the value of IS will be equal to, the value of IS will be equal to IR plus, let us assume this is ICR, this is ICR. So IR plus ICR. And we know the value of ICR. ICR is nothing but VR into Y. So ICR is equal to VR into Y. So now ICR is equal to VR into Y. So by the given information, we can draw the phasor diagram. So first what we can do is, first we will take the VR as reference. VR as reference. We have taken VR as reference, and the load is lagging in nature, so IR will be like this. So IR will be lagging an angle of phi R. So this angle is phi R. So now what we can do is, if you want to calculate VS, so IR, VS is equal to VR plus IS into Z, and we know that IS is equal to IR plus ICR. So first we will calculate this ICR. So ICR, we can see that the voltage applied across this Y is VR and current is ICR. So this is the pure capacitor. So ICR will be 90 degree. So ICR will be 90 degree leading with what? With VR. So this will be ICR. So what we can do is, we can simply draw like this ICR, this ICR, same magnitude ICR. So IR plus ICR will give what? This will give IS. IS, and now if we have the value of IS, then we can calculate the value of VS. So VS is equal to VR plus R into IR plus IR into XL plus IR into XL. So this will become VS. So this will become VS. So this is IES and this is VS. So the angle difference between these will be called as sending in power factor angle. So this and the power loss value will be equal to 3 times of IS square into R. So P loss is equal to 3 into IS square into R. So this is all about the uncompensated network. But what happened at no load? This is the important point we need to discuss. So at no load, if you are talking about at no load, so at no load, IR value will be equal to 0. IR value will be equal to 0, and we can redraw the circuit like this. This will be Z, this will be Z, and this will be Y, this will be Y simply, and this is Z and this is Y. And now after Z and Y simply, this is IR value will be equal to 0. IR value will be equal to 0 means no load. So simply, and the voltage will be same, that is VR. This will not be 0, we know that. And this is VS, this is VS, and this is IS, this is IS. So VS, IS. So now if at this time we are want to draw the diagram, this IS will be equal to ICR. We can simply see here. So first we can draw is, first we will draw the voltage VR taken as reference, and IR is equal to 0 means we will not write anything. And ICR is 90 degree leading with this VR. So ICR, we can write this ICR, and we can see that ICR value is equal to IS from the given diagram. So we know that VS value will be equal to this, VS value will be equal to VR plus IS into Z. So IS into R will be here, IS into R will be here, and IS into XL, and IS into XL will be here. So from here we can see that this value will be equal to VS. From here we can see VS value. From here we can see, and we can see that the value of VR is still greater than VS. So this is the first time we are seeing this phenomena. When receiving in voltage is greater than sending in, then the this phenomena is called as Ferranti effect. This phenomena is called as Ferranti effect, means the voltage value have been increased here. The voltage value has increased here. Voltage value has increased here. So voltage value has increased here. So now what we can do is voltage value has increased here. So this is called as Ferranti effect. And whenever the voltage value has increased, to minimize the voltage, what we can do is to reduce the Ferranti effect, we connect inductor in shunt. So now we are going to connect an inductor in shunt and see what will be the value in terms of ABCD. So now we are going to find out the value in terms of ABCD. So this is two port network. Let us assume this is ABCD. We have calculated this ABCD, and this is at no load. So when we, this is the bus, so load is not connected, but we will connect the inductor in shunt. So this will become load basically. This is not load, but if you will see, if you connect this inductor, this will behave as a load. This is VR and this is IR now. So VR upon IR will be equal to this LSH which we are connecting in shunt. So now we can see that we are connecting this inductor to become VR is equal to VS. VR is equal to VS. So we know the formula. VS is equal to A into VR plus B into IR. So the VS is equal to VR. VR is equal to AVR plus B into IR. So we can write VR common 1 minus A is equal to B into IR. So VR upon IR will be equal to B upon 1 minus A. So this is the shunt connected VR upon IR means ZLSH is equal to B upon 1 minus A. In the gate examination, the question has been asked on this same formula. So this is all about the incompensated network.